on the Main. Composer Thomas Morley was the most influential figure in the development of the English madrigal in Elizabethan England. His love of the Italian madrigal tradition, combined with a uniquely English point of view, gave birth to some of the most colorful music in all of English history. For tonight's performance, we were joined by our two faculty trumpet colleagues, Professor Scott Thornburg and Robert White, as well as student percussionist Zachary Savinsky. Later in the program, we will be inviting Professor Thornburg back to the stage for an important premiere by composer Greg Turner, honoring the life of former trumpet colleague, Dr. Stephen Jones. Our full forces have gathered on the stage for the next selection, Fanfare Schacht Jean by Richard Strauss. This arrangement by Royce Lumpkin is a shortened version taken from the highlights of Strauss's larger work, Festmusik der Schacht Jean, originally scored for 10 trumpets, 7 trombones, 2 tubas, and timpani. It is an example of occasional music or music written for a special occasion, which was a common practice throughout Europe at that time. Strauss dedicated the score to the Vienna Town Council in gratitude for having been awarded its Beethoven Prize the previous year. Dr. Hans von Bülow, Mahler heard a setting of the poem, Die Auferstehung, or the Resurrection, and he decided to use this as a foil for the first movement. The poem includes themes of redemption and hope for life after death. It appears halfway through the 30-minute finale as the chorus enters singing pianissimo the opening lines, "Rise again, yes, rise again, will you, my dust," after a brief rest. It is in this section where you hear the beautiful Auferstehung chorale. The version of the chorale we are playing tonight was arranged by trombone choir, or for trombone choir, by Arthur Davis. Thank you. selection, W. Gregory Turner, a trombonist and native of Michigan, currently residing in Reno, Nevada. His music can be found across all media, from feature films and television to CGI movies, video games, and apps. A composer of immense versatility, as well as a confessed technology junkie, Turner's love of all things orchestral, coupled with his experience as an ever-increasing list of genres, give him the ability to effortlessly move between projects as diverse as psychological thrillers and children's fantasy. Most recently, he has started expanding his compositional repertoire into the classical genre, especially for trombone. His works have been performed by renowned trombonist Colin Williams of the New York Philharmonic and Timothy Higgins of the San Francisco Symphony, just to name a few. From the Highest Heavens began as an idea in December 2018 after the sudden passing of our former beloved trumpet colleague, Dr. Stephen Jones. We are grateful to have Greg Turner with us today, and we would like to ask him to come forward to share his thoughts about the creation of this room.
Thank you.
Enrique Crespo wrote the Bruckner Etude, a tribute to Austrian composer Anton Bruckner, who gave the low brass instruments a leading role in orchestral music. Bruckner's compositions helped to define contemporary musical radicalism with their rich harmonic language, dissonances, unprepared modulations, and roving harmonies. Bruckner entertained a strong and unquestioning Catholic faith, and throughout his life composed numerous sacred works. We hope you enjoy this beautiful yet intense work for trombone choir.
Thank you.
inspired by a flyer for the Third Coast Trombone Retreat that featured 3 tenor trombonists and 2 bass trombonists. I thought it would be fun to create a work that not only pitted the 2 ranges of trombones in an adversarial mode at times, but also to explore the idea compositionally through melody, harmony, rhythm, and meter. As you will hear, the piece calls for exuberant, powerful, and propulsive playing with a touch of lyricism. Let the games begin. Thank you.
devastated, and we were just delighted. He flew out from Reno for this performance, and it's been a very special semester working on these pieces, and especially the tribute to Steve Jones. I wish you could have. Actually, I'm glad you did. I was going to say, I wish you could have seen me up here crying during that piece. Just thinking about that. But so touching and so moving, and I thought it was just a perfect piece. I'll come back and talk a little bit about Steve in a minute, but the first thing I want to do, this is a point in the concert where I'd like to recognize some of our graduates, some students who are about to graduate, and also some who have earned some accolades. And also I'm going to mention a few recent graduates who have, and this is risky for me to do this, because these guys have done so many great things, students in the studio over the last number of years. And I know I'm going to leave off a number of people. It's especially tricky with COVID the past 2 years, because we haven't had Toronto Choir. This is our very first concert in 3 years, I believe. So I know I'm missing some people and leaving some out, but I at least want to recognize, first of all, those who are graduating. And if I forget anybody, you guys let me know.
We will.
I know you will. Since Carrie said we will, let's start with Carrie. So, Carrie. Carrie auditioned for the studio 3 times. I'm going to tell the story.
You should.
She auditioned for the studio 3 times. I'm not going to tell the whole story.
Okay, up to you.
But she got in the 3rd time, and it's been a remarkable 4 years for her. She has done some amazing things and has really developed into just a fantastic trombonist. Music Ed is her thing, but she never put trombone second. I never felt that way. More times than not, you came into lessons and you cried and you said, I just feel like I'm not prepared and I feel terrible about it. So, is that right? Yeah, okay. It was always so serious for her. And you'll never know as a professor, I appreciate that.
Because okay, cool.
She's going to set the world on fire. When you get out, Gary, and you start, you start with your first high school band program, I have no doubt that you're just going to take the world by storm. So, Carrie,
thank you
for being part of this program. Allie Dotson, there you are. Allie is... high school audition when you were a senior. So I keep these videos, I kept them for years. And so we look back at Allie's audition, and it was a lot of fun. Well, it was fun for me. I think you're doing it too. Oh, you bet. She's done. Allie has just done phenomenal work. With some of these students, I can't say much about them because they're still waiting. It's during that period of time when they're reading on financial packages. They haven't made their decisions yet, and Allie is one of those. But she's got some large financial packages waiting her, and she's going to be moving on to grad school. And you've just been a delight to teach, Allie. It's been so much fun. So, Peter Sepkowski, here he is. College, I believe.
Yeah.
And so he's been here 2 years and it's gone fast. And three, I'm sorry. And I can't tell you, there are a few students that have made the kind of progress that Peter has made. He's just done phenomenal. And Peter came in with the intent he was going to be teaching public schools, and you're going to be great at that when you do. But by the time you got to be a senior, you said, I love trombone, and I think I want to continue at least for a master's. So Peter is one who's made a decision. He's going to be attending Youngstown State University next year. He is going to be a graduate assistant, His teacher will be, I think it's a 2006 graduate of this studio, Andy Mitchell. So that's really exciting for me to see you studying from Andy, and you're gonna do fantastic under him. So it's been a delight having you. Two students who graduated in December, and I got to mention them. Joseph Stoltz, I know he's watching online, Joseph. And Elijah Swan. And these guys were just amazing players. And Joseph, I think, is taking a year off. He's going to be hiking, for one thing. This has always been, I think I got Joseph into biking when I was here, road biking, because I bike about 2,500 miles a year. And Joseph bought a bike, and he's going to be hiking
Pacific Crest Trail,
all the way from the southern United States all the way up to Canada. So he's going to be doing that this summer and then pursuing grad school, and you can count on seeing great things of Joseph. Elijah Swan finished his master's degree here. Elijah has some graduate assistantships awaiting him. I can't say any more about it at this point because he hasn't made decisions yet on where he's going to go. But what a super guy. He's from, I think, Aurora, Illinois, I believe. So it's just wonderful teaching him. He again graduated in December. I've got to move quickly here because I'm taking too much time talking. So let me talk just a little bit. I'm so proud of these students and the work that they do and the things that they've done. And we've had several students in the studio. I could go back 3 years because of COVID, and I could sit here for the next half hour telling you some of the great things some students have done. But let me just talk about this year's. Adam McCoy, right here. Adam is graduating, and I think, I'm not sure, but you're going to stay in the area probably, so I'm excited about hopefully having him back in Toronto Choir next year. Adam has been, that's right, Adam has been just an amazing student, and he studied his undergrad from Gretchen McNamara, and he came in as a strong player, and he has just done phenomenal, and it's been an honor and a pleasure to teach you. And he was selected as a semifinalist at the Southeast Trombone Symposium, so he's going to be heading down south and competing, I think in what month?
July.
In July. Okay, very good. And Ian Warshaw, where are you? Right here. So, Ian. Ian has had a phenomenal 2 years. I'd like to say we actually talked him into doing a third year. He decided to stick around and do one more year and graduate next year because he wanted to spend a little more time on trombone. He has done some really amazing things. He has auditioned for the Chicago Civic, made associate trombonist in the Civic. Most recently, he was a finalist for the International Trombone Association's Van Haney Orchestral Excerpt Competition. Now, this is not an easy competition. This has people from all over the world auditioning, and he's in the top three. So he'll be traveling to the International Trombone Festival in July and competing against some really fantastic people. Peter, I'm going to mention you too, because Peter Lehman, he's actually his first year here, but he has one more year. I can't say too much about this because it's not supposed to be announced yet, but he just won a very important award for composition. So I'll leave it at that. So he's multi-talented, does a lot of things, and composition is one. And I'd be remiss if I didn't mention one of our students who's a high school senior will be joined in the studio, Gabby Stout. Gabby. We have people here from Ontario. That's great. So Gabby was selected as a Michigan Youth Arts Festival solo competition nominee. So she'll be competing next weekend, right?
On Friday.
So that's a big honor, and really excited for her. So congratulations, Gabby.
Right.
6 weeks with the Nashville Symphony. He's a 2015 graduate. He moved down to Nashville. He's recording down there. He's already breaking into the scene. How many of you watched the Grammys last night? Anybody here? So if you saw Lady Gaga and you saw a trombonist back there, that was Neil Maxa. Neil Maxa is a graduate of the studio, and he lives in Las Vegas and does some phenomenal things and backs up some world-class entertainers out there. Really proud of Neil. I want to mention one more, and I know, again, I'm forgetting people, but Tony Colella left the studio 2 years ago. He never graduated, and the reason was because he won a job in the studio as a he is now a member of the U.S. Army Field Band, which is the top touring band for the Washington, D.C. So you'll run across him many times. They'll come through the area. Tony is one of five trombonists, maybe four. Tony just got selected for the Joe Alessi Seminar, which is the highest level of seminar available to trombonists worldwide. I can't tell you how many trombonists from the U.S. were chosen, but I bet there weren't more than three. Tony is an amazing player, a great guy, and it was a lot of fun having him in the studio the brief time he was here. So I thought as a way to kind of honor our graduates and to recognize them, and at the same time keep the focus on Stephen Jones, a great colleague of mine. I learned so much from Steve. We had lunch together once a month. He was such a great trumpet player, such a great artist, such a great colleague. And he liked to attend the Drum and Bird concerts. So maybe four years ago, he attended. And he says, when you honor the graduates, it would be nice to maybe play the alma mater. And I thought, that's not a bad idea. So, of course, what Steve did was write it out for us. He wrote an arrangement. But he didn't stop with that. He wrote it in several keys. So we had the choice there of which one. So I picked the key of C. These guys didn't know I was going to do this. So they're learning about this for the first time. And they're going to recycle me. So, surprise. So before we play our last piece, we want to play the WMU Alma Mater. If you know it, go ahead and sing along. But here you are, the WMU Alma Mater. This is arranged by Professor Stephen Jones, and of course, an honor to him also.
The end of tonight's concert, and to celebrate the year of the Olympics, it seemed appropriate for us to end tonight's concert with this exciting arrangement of an Olympic theme from nearly commissioned composer John Williams to write a new Olympics theme as a follow-up to his 1984 Olympic fanfare and theme. This version you are about to hear tonight was arranged by Ball State University trombone professor and 2006 WMU trombone graduate Chris Van Hoff, who's watching online. Hi, Chris, and thank you. Thank you all for coming tonight. Once again, a very special thank you to trumpet professor Scott Thornburg and Robert White for their parts in this program, as well as Greg Turner for the very special tribute in honor of Steve Jones. We really appreciate that. And we hope you enjoyed the conversation.